Welcome to our first episode of 3D Printing Moves Explained. And we have finished our basic series in which we introduced the 7 additive manufacturing technologies with their features and characteristics. We've got a lot of questions from you, which we summarized in our 3D printing MIFs, which we think are very interesting for a broad audience, including home users. My name is Milena Riedl. I am a content manager here at Netzsch Analyzing and Testing. And this is Natalie Rudolph, our additive manufacturing specialist here at Netzsch.
Thanks, Milena.
Thank you, Natalie. So let's get started with our first question. A lot of people complain about the smell during 3D printing. Are these fumes toxic?
Yeah, that's a question we get a lot, that I even got a lot before this series, because a lot of people have decided to buy 3D printers for their kids, and a lot of people have them at home. So it is an important question, because ABS, for example, has this very sweet smell, and it just smells as if something is not right. There are really scientific methods to investigate the fumes and the volatiles that come out of a 3D printing filament or any material. We at Netzsch Analyzing and Testing have devices for that. The one that I would use for this, and that is used for this, starts with what we call thermogravimetric analysis, short TGA. And that allows to put a small amount of material in your device and heat it up under controlled conditions and see if it loses any weight as it's heating up. And that can be an indicator that something is released out of the material. And so to understand what fumes we really have, we couple that with another device that can analyze the fumes. There are two different types. One is called an FDIR. That really detects what kind of fume we have. It's like the fingerprint of the elements that are in that material. And the other is GCMS. That's a gas chromatograph that tells us what we have, and then it's coupled with a mass spectrometer that also tells us how much of that material we have. And that gives us really the complete picture of what comes out of a material and even how much. I brought with me an example of such a TGA curve first. What you see here is the mass of your sample as a function of temperature. And the first thing we see is that the mass stays pretty constant up until 300 degrees C. As indicated here, we have a mass loss of 1% that is attributed normally in the temperature range and because it's so small to moisture, so humidity that comes out of the filament. And then we see a drop in the mass that's really related to the material starting to burn. We call that degradation, and that's when you would really smell it, but that smells burned and like smoke. That's different to the other fumes that you pick up while printing. And that's also, it happens at temperatures that are much higher than typical 3D printing temperatures. So I mentioned we can also analyze what exactly the fumes are. So we did that in our lab for an ABS material. We picked the print temperature of 250 degrees C that's commonly used, and we extracted the volatiles that come out at that temperature in a GCMS. And you see different groups that are there, and you see the quantity. And the one I want to point out, because it's that distinct sweet smell, is styrene. And that is harmful in larger quantities. You can get a headache from it, for example. But that already means you're exposed to it too much anyways. Mm-hmm. So that is really a little bit tricky to work with. And that's why ABS smells more, and there's more talk about ABS being a little bit more harmful to use. Mm-hmm.
So what conclusion would you come out of with these measurements?
Yeah, so we know now that at a given temperature, in a very small sample, we have a certain quantity and also certain volatiles coming out. In an industrial setting, where you have a lot of printers, but you also have bigger space, you really want to know what the concentration is of these fumes and volatiles. So you would use environmental analytical equipment, set that up, and really see how the concentration of certain volatiles that are harmful, you would already detect for specific ones, how much of that you have over the duration of a day, depending on how much many printers you have, your exhaust system being on and off, and also if it's summer or winter, because that can also have an effect.
Do you have a recommendation for private households?
Yes, so that would, the best there would definitely be ventilation, because it's the easiest to do. So keep the room you're printing in ventilated, open a window, and ideally not stay in that room. You could always, and I think a lot of people do that, you could start a print in the evening and let it run overnight. So when you come in the morning and you want to check on it, go in, open the window right away, and get that ventilation going. Ventilation can also be a problem because it can lead to warpage of prints, because you get a draft of air. And in that case, if that's really a problem, you could also consider looking into a printer that already has an exhaust system built in. There are more and more of these printers out there, and some even have filters that filter out certain volatiles completely.
Great, thank you. Thank you for watching. We will see you next week with our next episode.